I grew up in Massachusetts, and I had a love for music from an early age. My dad used to play a lot of records, a lot of jazz records, and we'd listen to music all the time at home. But my real love was with rock and roll music. I hooked up with a bunch of bands, and we found ourselves in the studio. It was the first time I'd ever met a producer and engineer, and I heard the producer say to the engineer, "I think we need to put a little 10K on the snare." And I freaked out. I had never heard what a 10K was. I didn't know where you put it on a snare. It was at that very moment that I said, I'm gonna learn how to be an engineer. I moved out to Los Angeles. I ended up working at Rumbo Studios, and that's where I was an assistant engineer on Guns N' Roses' Appetite for Destruction. The producer, Mike Klink, he was out doing a favor for David Foster's sister, and David Foster came into the studio and asked Mike if he knew any young, hungry engineers, and Mike recommended me. David Foster hired me right away, and that's right where my shift went from rock and roll into the pop world. My name is Dave Reitzas. I'm a recording engineer, mixer, producer, father, husband, music lover, and I'm originally from Massachusetts, and I've been out in Los Angeles for 33 years, 9 months, and 12 days. When I started working with David Foster, one of the early gigs that we did was with Natalie Cole, Unforgettable, Natalie Cole, Nat King Cole. We did Whitney Houston, The Bodyguard. We did the early Celine Dion, Madonna, Barbra Streisand, Michael Bolton, Frank Sinatra, Peter Gabriel, Color Me Bad, Gloria Estefan. Throughout my career, I have 6 Grammys and an Emmy. I was actually the first engineer to go up on stage with an artist to accept a Grammy, and that was with Madonna and William Orbit. One thing that I did learn that was crucial to probably the rest of my career was that it is about the heart and the emotion that goes into the song. I remember back around 1991, I first heard the Genelec 1031s. From the very moment that I put our music through it, it was a whoa moment. It was like, oh my God, this is what we've been waiting for. You knew that when the artist took it home to play it, that they were gonna hear a great mix. And it gave me a nice boost of confidence that finally I'm hearing accuracy, I'm hearing consistency and continuity. The mid-2000s, I ended up getting a small pair of the 8020s, and then eventually that turned into the 8320s. Now for about the past 6 months, I'm on the 8351s. When you first hear the music that you love through a beautiful pair of speakers, it's just life-changing, because that's listening to music through speakers is the deciding factor of everything that I do. The technology of the current Genelecs, it's just perfect. Knowing that wherever I go with the 8351s, I can use the GLM to calibrate the speakers to the room that I'm in, it just gives me a great consistency and just a good feeling to know that every change that I make is accurate and it's going to be translated well. The first thing that I do when I get to the studio or to whatever room I'm going to be in is I'll set up the 8351s and grab the GLM system. It takes about 5 minutes to calibrate it. It just makes things a lot easier. I want to make the people that I work with happy. That's my ultimate goal. When I've made an artist happy, I've done my job correctly. There's nothing like seeing the smile on the face of an artist that sits in this chair and you play back your mix, and they smile, and they give you that look of approval, and it's just the feel-good thing that I do this for. The bottom line is that I'm in the business to make great music that creates an emotion. I'm just looking for the best way to make the best music for creating the best emotions. I want people to feel something.